Friendship Baptist Church in the Colony. I'm Senior Pastor Gregory C. Trotter, and I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our live streaming program here at Friendship Baptist Church. Let me take this opportunity to welcome you into our worship service. Our prayer is that you will be blessed and that you will receive that blessing that God has in store for you. So sit back and enjoy the worship service. We welcome you to the Friendship Baptist Church in the Colony.
The waves and the currents that seem so fierce, but in the word of God, I've got an anchor, and it keeps me steadfast and unmovable despite the tide.
Amen, amen. Amen. One time for the Father. Amen. One time for the Son. And amen. One time for the precious Holy Spirit. You know, it's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. You know, because somebody's clock is still going off. And that's all it's doing is going off. But, you know, getting up because the Lord has called them home. There's a very familiar passage here that I love also, because you know we have a whole lot of them, so you can pick and choose any day. Galatians 6, starting at verse 9, and it says, "Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due seasons we shall reap if we faint not. As we have therefore the opportunity, let us do good unto all men, and especially them of that are of the household of faith." So, I won't preach that. I'll just say, act right with the people in the church. Let us pray. Father, it's once again, dear Lord. Father, at the 11 o'clock hour, dear Father, you let your children come into your house to praise your holy name. Father, you didn't take an age or a size, dear Father. You didn't take a number. You just said, come. And we all begin to come, dear Lord. So, Father God, we pray for this service, dear Lord. We pray for the preached word that will be preached this morning. We pray for the choir, dear Father, that they'll render songs unto you, dear Father. We pray that the Holy Ghost will come in right now, dear Father. We ask for your forgiveness, dear Father, for the sins we've committed, dear Father. And we pray that you will do all that you said, because surely, Lord, we trust you and we thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And thank you, Lord. You're in the hands of the deacons.
Morning, Friendship.
Morning.
I'm Deacon Wallace. This is Deacon Lyons, and we're here to lead the devotion this morning. Let's start out by just giving the Lord a hand clap of praise. I have two questions for you. First question: has anyone within the sound of my voice been delivered or had a blessing they received from the Lord this week? If so, say amen.
Amen.
I have a second question for you. Is there someone that's still in need of a blessing, whether it be spiritual, financial, health, or whatever? Is anyone, and if that's so, you don't have to tell me what it is, but just say amen.
Amen.
And so I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, God is able. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. With that being said, the scripture is coming from Ephesians, 3rd chapter, starting at the 16th verse. And it reads, "I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the saints to grasp the whole, the wide, the long, the height, and the depth that is the love of Christ. and to know that his love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to unmeasurably more than do what we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at his work within us. And to him be glory in the church and in the Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and most of all, the doers of his holy word.
Good afternoon. As Deacon Wallace was reading that, I thought to myself, how many of us really, really understand that tomorrow is not promised? You know, we say that, we read it, but I wonder if we really understand it. It's only through God's grace that he allows us to be here. It's only through his grace that he allows us to even get up and walk out of this sanctuary. And so I'm thankful that he allowed me to be here this morning. And I would just ask that we would all turn our hearts and thoughts to him as we go into prayer, that truly God is the only one that's able, and he's the one who has brought us here.
Amen.
Okay. Heavenly Father, it's once again, Lord, I just come thanking you, Father, for this opportunity one more time to just be able to bow and ask you, Father, for forgiveness for anything that I may have done, knowingly or unknowingly, Father, that was unright in your eyesight, Father. Father, and I just thank you because without you, I would not be here. Without you, I would not have had these years on this earth.
Forgiveness for anything that I may.
So, Father, I thank you for your blessings. I thank you for your grace. And, Father, I ask that you would continue to bless those that are here in this sanctuary and those that are on their way, Father. And those that think about you, Father, and have truly tried to do your will, Father. Because none of us are perfect. And so, Father, we just thank you for allowing us to continue on, even though we may not be doing everything right, Father. But Father, I ask that you would help us so that we could tweak ourselves, tweak our bodies, tweak our minds, tweak the things that we're doing so that we would do a better job for you, Father. Continue to lift us up so that we would continue to be stronger to do your will, Father. And Father, this is a long day today, Father, but we know that you can give us the strength. We're here today. We're here for our service, Father, but we've got to go some miles to support our pastor, Father. Father, I ask that you would give us the traveling grace, no matter whether we're in our individual cars, in the bus, wherever we might be, Father, traveling to that destination, Father. I ask that you would give us the strength to do your will. Give us the strength to support our pastor, Father. Help us so that we may go there, Father, and be strong, and then be able to return back to our homes this evening, Father. And Father, we can't say enough about how much you've done for us, Father. No matter if I stayed here for an hour, Father, I couldn't tell you how much you've done for me and how much I appreciate and how much I thank you for all you've done, Father. I thank you for my family, my children, my wife, my aunts, nieces, everybody, Father. I just thank you because if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here, Father. I thank you for my pastor. I thank you for my brothers and sisters, Father, on the deacon board, my family, Christian family, Father. I just thank you, Father, because you are the only one that has allowed us to be here, Father. You are so wonderful, Father, and I thank you so much, Father. And Father, when we come to the end of our journey, Father, we ask that you would receive us. In your Son Jesus' name, amen. We'll now turn it over to the hands of the choir. Thank you so much.
Praise the Lord in this place. Praise the Lord in this place. Can I get everybody to stand to your feet this morning? Help us welcome in the Lord this morning. Anybody happy to praise him? Anybody happy to be here? Let's make some noise, choir. Is everybody praise him? Everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody praise him.
Said everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord. Everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord. Said everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord. I was created to give God praise.
I was created to give God praise.
Come on, y'all, make some noise in this place this morning. Let's do it in three parts, unified. Everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody praise him.
Yeah. Said everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody praise him.
Help us out, congregation. Said everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord. Said everybody praise him. Everybody bless the Lord. Yeah. I was created to give God praise.
I was created to give God praise.
Yeah.
Woo!
All right, here we go, choir. Here we go. Everybody praise the Lord.
Everybody praise the Lord.
Everybody praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Said everybody praise the Lord. Said everybody, everybody, everybody praise him. Everybody, everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody, everybody, everybody praise him. Everybody, everybody,
everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody, everybody, everybody praise him. Everybody, everybody,
everybody bless the Lord. I was created to give. Together this morning. Come on.
Everybody praise the Lord.
Everybody praise the Lord. Said everybody praise the Lord. Said everybody praise the Lord. Said everybody clap your hands. Said everybody clap your hands. Said everybody do your dance. Said everybody do your dance. Said let's shift this atmosphere. Said let's shift this atmosphere. Oh, let's shift this atmosphere. Said, let's shift this atmosphere. And I decree healing. Somebody's about to get healed. I decree healing. Cancer, you got to go. I decree healing. Whoa, I decree healing. And I'm speaking miracles. Speaking miracles, speaking it over your life. I'm speaking miracles in every area. I'm speaking miracles. I don't know about you, but I need a breakthrough. Oh, I need a breakthrough. Yeah, I need a breakthrough. Last time, y'all.
Hey, everybody praise him.
Everybody bless the Lord.
Everybody put your hands together this morning and give God some praise. Let's give God some praise in the house this morning. I know he's done something for you this morning. I know he's done things for me today. He woke me up this morning. He got me here safely this morning. And I just want to say that everybody this morning that God is able to do anything. No matter what it is that you need, all you have to do is go to him and ask him. Amen. Exceedingly, abundantly, above all you could ask of him, according to the power that worketh in you. You, God is able to do just what he said he would do. Yeah, he's gonna fulfill every promise to you. So don't give up on God, and he won't give up on you. He's able. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's able. Yes, he is. Come on, sing it with me, choir.
God's able to do
just what he said. My God is able. Yes, he is. Take it up one time, choir.
God's able to do
just what he said.
What he said.
Oh, he's gonna fulfill it.
He's gonna fulfill
every promise.
Every promise.
So don't give up.
Don't give up on God.
Yes, he is. He's able. He's able. Yes, he is. My God is able. My God is able. Listen to me. Oh, 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 he's able.
Oh, oh,
yes, he is. Yes, he is.
He's able.
Say yeah.
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 Yes, he is. Hallelujah. Yes, he is. He's able. Thank you, Jesus.
Friendship. First, giving honor to God, Pastor Gregory Trotter, other ministers on the roster, family, friends, and guests. These are your announcements for September the 20th, 2015. Pastoral installation for Reverend Autry Williams will be held this evening at 4:30 p.m. at Providence Missionary Baptist Church in Montalba, Texas. Your support is encouraged. Wednesday Bible study will be held at 9:30 a.m. and 7 o'clock p.m. The Old Time Gospel Hour midweek service will be held at 8 o'clock p.m. September 22nd, financial peace classes begin. Please see Sister Thadine Hernandez to register and for additional information. September 26th, 33 the series, volume 2, Solomon's Porch at 9 a.m. Third Pastor and Wife Appreciation Celebration, honoring Reverend Gregory Trotter and First Lady Doris Trotter, Sunday, September 27th at 11 a.m. Guest speaker will be Pastor Jerry W. Daly of Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church, San Antonio, Texas. The theme, The Steps of a Godly Man, Psalms 37:23. Attire for this occasion is brown and cream. October 3rd. Men's Ministry Breakfast, 9:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. October 11th, Annual Men's Day, also on October 11th, Deacon Ordination at 3 o'clock p.m. October 14th, Annual Church Meeting. Attention online givers, all members who are using the Friendship Connection online giving, please log in and reestablish your giving options. And now, a memorable quote from the pastor's desk. Sins have many tools, but a lie is the handle that fits them all. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Pastor Gregory Trotter in the body of Friendship Baptist Church of the Colony. Your church announcements can be found in your bulletin, on the church bulletin board, or you may log on to friendshipbaptistofthecolony.org. Thank you and have a blessed week.
Church, can I ask you a question? Yes. What can God do?
He can do anything. Yeah.
Come on now. What can God do?
He can do anything.
What can God do?
He can do anything.
My God. Him.
He can do anything.
Who, Lord, have you ever tried him?
He can do anything.
Who, have you ever tried him?
He can do anything.
God can. God can do. What can God do?
He can do anything.
Who, Lord, can I get one witness?
He can do anything.
Oh, do, God can do.
He's doing it right now. 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 He's been good. He's been kind. He's been wonderful all the time. He is. He is. He is. He is. He is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Oh, God is. He's working. God is. He's working. I feel him moving. I feel him moving. I feel him moving. He's working, he's working, he's working, he's working, he's working, he's working. Can't you see? It's about time for a miracle. How many believe it? Clap your hands, y'all. Woo! Do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. So let's call on him. Oh, how many need to praise him in the land? Praise him in here. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Take it up. On. Woo, woo. He's so good. He's so good. Praise him.
Thank you, choir. Let's give a hand clap for the choir this morning, everybody. Thank you, choir. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Thank you, choir. First, giving honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, my pastor, and the other ministers that labor with him, and to each one of you, my sisters and brothers in Christ. For it is at this time in our service we pause to welcome our guest. So for those of you that are visiting with us today, we'd like for you to please stand and remain standing. All of our guests, please stand. Thank you. Thank you. Greetings and welcome. On behalf of our pastor, Pastor Gregory Trotter, our First Lady, Sister Doris Trotter, and you, the members of Friendship Baptist Church, we welcome you today. Thank you for coming out to visit with us. We hope that you will get a blessing from the services today, and if the church staff can welcome you in any way, we welcome the opportunity. For here at Friendship, we believe, as it is written, to let brotherly love continue, to be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. Hebrews 13:1-2. So to each one of you, to let you know just how welcome you really are, the members of Friendship will be standing and extending their hearts and hands to each one of you in love. And we ask that you come and visit with us again. Friendship, let's welcome our visitors. Thank you.
Thank you. morning, Friendship. We're here again to highlight the upcoming celebration. Upon entering the sanctuary this morning, each of you should have received another invitation. This invitation contains all of the details regarding the celebration in terms of the colors, theme, etc. But this invitation is unlike the usual invitation that you'll receive, which requires an RSVP. With this invitation, you can bring as many members, friends, family as you'd like. The only thing that's required is your presence and your spirit for worship. During the worship service, as we conclude the 11 o'clock worship service, we'll continue to fellowship with dinner in the gymnasium in the fellowship hall. Amen?
Wow, Friendship. That tells me that we have exactly 7 days left before our third appreciation service of our awesome Pastor Gregory C. Trotter. And Friendship, there's nowhere in the world that we can forget our wonderful, beautiful, elegant First Lady, Doris Trotter. This celebration will take place on Sunday, September the 27th, during the 8 and 11 a.m. service. Now, Friendship, I don't know about you, but when a celebration of this magnitude gets this close, I get excited. Yeah, right. I get excited about all the things that we'll experience during this celebration. We'll experience songs of praise from our amazing award-winning choir. We'll have songs of praise and dance through praise through ministry and dance through our fantastic youth department. Amen. And we'll have many, many more exciting things to experience. Oh, but Friendship, that's not the most exciting and important thing that we'll experience. We'll experience the Word of God preached by none other than Pastor Jerry W. Daly of Macedonian Missionary Baptist Church, all the way from San Antonio, Texas. Amen? Amen. Now, we will have a table set up in the gym after 8 and 11 a.m. service for you to place your expressions of love and gift of appreciation for our pastor and First Lady. We will also have an autograph book for you to sign and write special notes and encouragements for the First Lady and Pastor Trotter. Amen?
Thank you.
Well, good morning, Friendship.
Good morning.
We thank God for another blessed day that He's allowed us to see.
Yes.
Amen. His grace and mercy and allowing us to be in His house of worship one more time. Amen. I want to say to those of you who are our guests this morning, welcome to Friendship. We are so glad to have you. This worship experience would not be the same without you. Amen. We pray that you would receive that blessing that God has for you. Please come back and share with us again. And all of those of our guests, we're going to ask you if you would just remain with us just for a brief moment. After this worship service, we just want to show a little love to you, to fellowship with you, and to get to know you better, and for you to get to know us better. Amen. I promise you, we won't hold you long. Amen. I want to welcome those who are joining us by live streaming. We welcome you into this worship service as well. You heard the announcements concerning Pastor Autry Williams, 4:30 this afternoon in Montalvo, Texas. We will be going down to install him as the new pastor of the Providence Baptist Church. Amen. We need our ushers, our choir, deacons, ministers, members. We need all of you who are able to go. Amen. We have two buses that should be coming shortly. Amen. For those who cannot drive. Amen. Let me say again, those who are not able to drive. Amen. Those who cannot drive, those who are not able to drive, not just those who don't want to drive. Amen. Because there are some who cannot drive, and we want them to be able to ride the bus, if at all possible. Amen. If you can, let someone have your seat on the bus. Amen. Amen. I appreciate you. I thank God for your support. Amen. For Pastor Archer Williams and for myself. Amen. On next Sunday, we will be celebrating 3 years as pastor and wife of the Friendship Baptist Church here in the colony. It's a humbling experience, amen, but yet a thankful experience. We are so thankful that God seen fit to choose you and to choose us to bring us together. Amen. On behalf of Sister Trotter and myself, we say to you today, thank you so very much for loving us and caring for us and always being there and praying for us. Amen. Amen. We thank you, Friendship, so very much. Amen. You heard the announcement that on October the 11th at 3 o'clock, we will be having deacon ordination for those young men whom we have been training the past few months. Amen. They will be coming in, amen, being ordained on October the 11th at 3 o'clock. Amen. So put that on your calendar as we come and support, amen, these young men as they are being ordained as deacons. On yesterday, we had three different funerals, for one for a member of our church and then two members of our church who had loved ones, amen, to pass away. Amen. Sister Lakeisha Wooden, her grandmother passed away, amen, and her funeral was on yesterday. Also, Sister Sandra Clement, she's one of our members, amen. She passed away earlier in the week, and she was funeralized on yesterday. Please be in prayer for her son and daughter and her husband and their family. Please keep them in your prayers. Also, Sister Wanza Moore's mother was funeralized on yesterday as well. Amen. We are talking about them today, but we don't ever know, amen, where death lies for us. Amen. All right. We've got a lot we need to do in a short period of time so that we can get where we need to be. But while we're here, we're going to praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Now, I've agreed to go to Mount Auburn, Texas, but my first responsibility is to Friendship Baptist Church in the colony. Amen. Amen. So if the Holy Spirit moves in such a fashion that we are here a little longer than we planned, so be it. Amen, because when I leave here, I want to hear God's welcome voice saying, well done. Amen. So don't hold back on your worship because we are trying to get out of here. Amen. We're here for no other reason but to worship God in spirit and in truth. Amen, because we can leave here and not make it there. Amen, amen. But if we worship him in spirit and in truth, that old devil will be scared of us. Amen. And he won't bother us as we are traveling up and down the dangerous highway. Amen. Our diggers are going to come at this time for our tithes and for our offering. Amen.
Good morning again, Friendship. Let's give a hand clap of praise for the service thus far. Amen. And before we receive our offering, we go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we just want to thank you for, Father, this offering that we're receiving in your name. Father, we pray that you bless it, Father, and we pray that you bless the cheerful giver as well as the one who had the heart to give but not the means, Father. We pray that all will be used for the building up of your kingdom on this side, Father. In Jesus' name I do pray. Thank God and amen. Amen.
Shaking together, running over, running over. This is altar call. Does anyone right now need rest from your labor? Anybody who needs reconciliation because you've been out? Anybody need regeneration today? Why don't you come to the altar? Bring it to God right now. You're burdened down. Bring it to God right now. Why don't you come? Let us pray. God, our Father, we're not bringing this to anybody today. We don't come down in front of this altar for just anyone today. We're not bringing our burdens just to anybody today. We right now laying them at the foot of the cross. We laying them right now at the one who was in the beginning with God. We laying them right now as the one who was not only with God, but is God. We laying it down at the one who decided to come out and say, light be, and everything start right then and there. And Lord, we just not bringing this to anybody. We bringing it to you this morning. We just say thank you for what you've already been in our lives. We say thank you for all that you've already been in our lives. And then we say thank you for in everything. We gonna bless your name in everything today. We gonna bless your name in all of the good, all the bad, all of the things we don't understand, all of the things we don't know, all of the things that's hurting us, all the things that's holding us back, all of the things that you are charged over with. We thank you for everything. Thank you, Lord. Now we just come confessing, saying, Lord, we hadn't done all that you told us to do. We've gone contrary to some of the things that we should not have done. But we say right now, create in us a clean heart, renewing us a right spirit. Give us that spirit that runs from heart to heart. Let the mind be in us, which was also in Christ Jesus today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Now we come and we're going to lay it all right here. Some of us have been laboring and laboring and laboring, but right now we need relief this morning. We need relief from the headaches, the heartaches, the letdown, the put down, the knockdown. We need relief today. And we want to rest in you. You say, come unto me, all that labor and a heavy laden, and we right now bring it to you. Help us today. Help us. Some of us have fallen down, Master. But I heard you say, now unto him who's able to keep you from falling. So we just stumble. We have not fallen. We just stumble a little bit right now. Pick us up, turn us around, and take us right back in the way that we need to go. Thank you, Lord. Now, whatever we brought down here, Lord, whatever we came down with, Master, we're just going to give them to you. We ask right now that you'd bless this man that's going to stand and preach your gospel today. Relieve him of every headache, every heartache, everything that might keep him from doing what you've called him to do. We ask that you'd bless the pastor of this church and keep his family safe from all dangers, seen and unseen. Bless him and ask him to be able to bring a word even today as we go down to Montalvo. Now we ask for traveling grace even beforehand, that we travel down south and be able to come back tonight. But let your will be done. Thank you, Lord. Now, as we go from this place, as we head back to the pew, we promise right now we're going to leave it. Whatever relief we needed, we leave it here. Whatever reconciliation we needed, we leave it right here. Whatever regeneration, we leave it right here. Master, let your spirit rest, rule, and abide. And we will just praise your name In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Amen. And thank God.
It's preaching time.
Oh, hallelujah.
Reverend Michael Byrd will come with a word from the Lord.
Amen.
People of God said amen.
Amen.
Said amen again.
Amen.
Have your Bibles turned with me to the Gospel of Luke, the 8th chapter. Commencing at the 22nd. Verse. Luke chapter 8, verses 22 through 25, we'll read in your hearing. And for the brevity of time, it reads on this wise. Now it came to pass on a certain day that he went into a ship with his disciples, said unto them, let us go unto to the other side of the lake. They launched forth. But as they sailed, he fell asleep. There came down a storm of wind on the lake, and they were filled with water and were in jeopardy. They came to him and awoke him, saying, Master, Master, we perish. Then he arose and rebuked the wind and the raging of the water, and they ceased, and there was a calm. He said unto them, where is your faith? They being afraid wondered, saying one to another, what manner of man is this? For he commanded even the winds and the water, and they obeyed him. You may be seated. To God our Father, Holy Spirit, our company keeper, Jesus, our Savior, to Pastor Trotter, First Lady Sister Trotter, to the deacons, trustees, leaders of this church, my brothers and sisters in Christ and in creation, I'd like to put a tag on this text. And to the, at least I forget, my ecclesiastical engineers, my brothers, to share with me this burden and labor of the gospel. I want to talk from this morning, Jesus, the storm stopper. Let us pray. God, our Father, we come to thee just thanking thee for this another day. Another opportunity just to behold your face. Your grace and your mercy all around us, your love all within us, your care all upon us. Lord, it's our preaching hour, but we ask in thee for preaching power. If I'm too far up, bring us down. If I'm too low, bring us up. If I'm too far out, bring us in, Lord, and use us. Not for fame, not for reputation, but that men might believe. Some woman. Some little boy, some little girl, some man may come running. What must I do to be saved? Lord, may your word be glorified. May the saints be edified. And may Satan be horrified. In Jesus' name we pray a servant's prayer. Thank God and amen. Everybody I know, everybody you know too, talks about the weather. We listen to the weather on our local news day in and day out. Plan our lives around it. Talk about it because that's all we can do is talk about it. In fact, the meteorologist is the only job I know that still gets paid for being wrong. With all of our abilities to harness energy, with all of our abilities to advance scientifically and draw out the resources, we can't do anything about the weather. And on a spiritual note, we should know that Christians' lives is not without trouble. Job reminds us, and he says that the man born of a woman is but a few days, and those days are full of trouble. But the question this afternoon is, where is Jesus in the midst of our storm? How do we practice faith in the stormy moments of our life? How do we respond in the face of a life-threatening situation? Well, I'm glad you asked those questions, but those questions and others are raised in our text today. So allow me to set the scene, to recapitulate the narrative. According to Mark chapter 4, because there's other gospels that speaks of this account, Jesus had been teaching the crowd and they were lined up on the shore of the Sea of Galilee. His pulpit was a boat anchored just off the shore. It was evening and Jesus had finished his teaching. So he instructed his disciples by saying, "Let us go to cross the lake by boat to the other side." They left the crowd behind. And that's a fresh word for somebody today. Sometimes you need to get away from the crowd. What the disciples did not know that this 6-mile journey from the northwest tip of the Sea of Galilee to the eastern side of the sea, where they had to go to Gerasenes lived, revealed their fears and faith, or lack thereof. To answer the question that some may be wondering this morning, the reason Jesus needed to go to Gerasenes is because he never missed an appointment. You Bible readers know he had an appointment with a crazy man that had 6,000 demons that was possessing him. And I know he was glad that Jesus showed up when he did and that God never forgets an appointment. Back to the text. The Sea of Galilee or Lake of Galilee is small. It's about 15 miles north to the south at this furthest point and about 7 miles from east to west. It's the largest freshwater lake in the world. The surface of it is 680 feet below sea level. Sort of sits in the Jordan Rift Valley. Around it are 2,000 feet mountains on either side. When there is a squall that comes up, it can rise very suddenly. A squall is a sudden violent gust of wind or a localized storm bringing heavy rain or sleet. And these mountains serve as a funnel through which the winds can blow with great velocity. To make the text come alive. Join me in getting on this boat with Jesus. And let's go over to the other side. And other disciples, after all, are part of this, because if you know what a disciple is, it's not an apostle. Now, don't mean the apostles were not present, but a disciple is nothing more than a learner or a student of Jesus. And notice, according to Mark chapter 4, 36, that was not the only boat or only ship that was on the water. It says there were other little ships that took this journey as well. There's a few universal principles we need to apply on this trip. First off, it's not the love boat. We're not going to Fantasy Island and tattoos not there, talking about the plane. I know I'm dating myself. Somebody know what I'm talking about. The Lake of Galilee is the sea of life. The storm represents any and all kinds of adversity that we experience. And the boat is our helplessness to overcome this adversity. Now, the Bible says once we get on the boat, that when we started to sail, the master, Jesus, he went to sleep. He went to sleep. So no, just before the disciples saw one of the most awesome display of his deity, they got a glimpse of his humanity. He went to sleep. After all, he was tired from a full day of teaching. And the human side of him was wore down, wore out. You know how it is. And for you theologians, this word for sleep was only used once in the New Testament. You won't find it any other place, because if you find another word, you won't find it saying Jesus slept. And we know, because he never sleeps nor slumbers. He never slept. The human side of him was tired, only used once in the New Testament. And you will not find it again. So Jesus, according to some writings, was in the hinder part of the boat. And others went on to say he was behind them. And I submit to you today that any time that Jesus is behind you and beneath you, you're headed towards a storm. Verse 23 says, after he fell asleep, there came down a storm on the lake, and they were filled with water. And we're in jeopardy, the Bible says. Well, that brings me to my first point. And the first thing I see is this in this text is, I see the commotion on the sea. Okay. Commotion on the sea. And just like our lives, sometimes we're tossed to and fro. Like little rag dolls, little Raggedy Ann dolls, in fact, thrown across the room. Is there anybody here that's willingly tries and hunts and seek for a storm? Do you go looking for trouble? Oh, I know we have those tornado chasers, as crazy as they may be. But I'm talking about a bona fide storm. A tsunami is showing up and you're out looking for it because you want it to hit you. That would rattle your brain. You know, have you ever been in a situation where you've gotten bad news that just shook you up? You go to the doctor and he says, I'm sorry. There's nothing else I can do. I've done all that I can. A phone call rings in the middle of the night and you're scared to answer it because you know it's always, or most of the time, bad news. And if it hadn't been for bad news, sometimes there'd be no news at all. An unexpected divorce or decree shows up. You walk in the house and your wife or your husband said, for no reason at all, baby, I want a divorce. I'm out of here. An eviction notice a week after you got your job laid off from your house. I'm talking about a bona fide storm. Whatever it is that's eating at you represents the commotion on the sea and the commotion in our life. Now, don't be guilty of being a fair-weather Christian. Bible says that no one, after putting his hand to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom. God does not need any coward soldiers in his army. Because storms, like some house guests, just show up unannounced. Without any warning or any signal, any text message or tweet, they just show up. Storms are sudden and they cause commotion. Anyone ever heard these heart-wrenching words? I'm sorry to tell you, but now you have cancer, and it's in the worst stage that it can be. There's nothing, it's too late, I can't operate. I submit to you today, that's a storm. This just happened to a co-worker of mine. And not long ago, we buried her sister. She buried her sister on last week just because of that. So I know that storms show up suddenly and just show up unannounced. See, I've lived long enough to know that we're not always set sail smooth on a ship. But these men were expert fishermen and was accustomed to the storms. And on this particular sea, but there was something unique about this storm. And the reason it could have been so unique is because of what Matthew's account said in chapter 8, verses 24. Matthew said that he called a great tempest. In the original language, the word tempest is seismos, where we get our word seismograph from, which is an instrument to measure and record details of an earthquake for force and duration. And as the boat filled with water, it was now in the danger of sinking. And it appears that not only was it filling up with water because it was going through an earthquake, everything was shaking. All may be lost. They got scared. They got nervous. They remembered that we got the men on board. They just talked on the side of the seashore. They forgot what Jesus told them also, which was, let us go unto the other side. God never told us there would not be storms in our life. But I'm here to tell you, because you're here, he's telling us to let us go onto the other side. See, I know my fellow cell mates, and I ain't talking about jail cell, S-A-I-L mates, that it can be rough. But God has told us he will never leave us nor forsake us. And if Jesus is on the boat, and if he's asleep, we need to know that hope is not lost. So know this, perhaps Satan was behind this terrible storm, an earthquake, in an attempt to kill Jesus because his appointed time had not yet come. But Jesus slept through it all. What the text teaches us is that even when you go in the way of God, in the way he commands us to go, there will be trouble. We're not exempt from trouble, commotions, and storms. The disciples were in the boat, and because they had been in a storm before, I'm sure they tried everything but doing nothing. They're trying everything in their power to fight, to survive, struggling with this storm. Sounds like us, don't it? Fight, we struggle, do everything we can. Look at the disciples and us as we're bailing out the water on our boat. As fast as we can. Sweat rolling down our faces in driving rain and wind. It was a movement without achievement. It was activity without accomplishment. It was what I call bubblegum Christianity. Movement without achievement. You'll catch that on your way home. The disciples are physically strong, but the problem is their strength is trapped inside this boat. And this boat is trapped inside this storm. So what do we do? Well, that leads me to my second point. And that is in verse 24. We hear the cries of the disciples. I wonder, because there are other ships on the sea, if just perhaps they cried out for help. You ever been in a storm and call your friends or call your loved ones or call your family members? That seemed like nothing happened. But sometimes when you're in a storm, there's no help to be found. Yeah. And maybe they were dealing with their own storms themselves. I don't know. The Bible says they were on the water. And they could have been fighting their own storms in their little bit of ship. I don't know. But I do know, on a calm day, that on a natural application of the location where Jesus taught, his voice could carry back and forth across the water because of the location of the Sea of Galilee. He strategically taught there because he didn't have to speak as loud, because his voice would carry because of the amplification. But in a storm, if a person tries to yell at their highest pitch, their voice would project. The wind would slap their words right back in their mouth. And in a storm, we find ourselves out of touch, out of communication. And that's why storms can be such a lonely place. Marriage with storms are a lonely place. Singleness with storms can be a lonely place. Yeah. Physical illness and tragedy is a terrible lonely place, because storms isolate us. Storms distract us. Storms disturb us. And oftentimes we are in danger, or feel like it, when we are in a storm. We're not strong enough to deal with these storms, because they can destroy us. In a storm, we must learn, as did the disciples, that there is only one to whom we can go. It's in the text. We cry on everybody else first. And then at the end, after when that all we could do, now we want to call on God. Seems like we need to twist that thing. Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all these other things. So they said, Master, Master. Y'all better get with me. I'm getting ready to go to my seat. Master, Master, we perish. And this word perish means to declare that one must be put to death. The storm was so bad, they felt like they were about to die. You ever been there? Seemed like all hope was lost. Seemed like death was a better alternative. This storm made them feel like they were about to go under. This brings me to my last point. And that is the composure and calmness of Christ, which is where their faith should have been in the very first place. The question before us this morning is, did they wake up? Did they wake him up to rebuke the storm and winds? Maybe they just wanted another hand to bail out water. After all, he was sound asleep. Perhaps if he was like me, he was snoring from a hard day of labor. Notice the only thing that woke him up was the cry of a needed soul. Think about it. It was one of the violent storms that ever hit, because they dealt with storms before. Mark account said that it was an earthquake and everything was shaken up. But Jesus was sound asleep. But when he heard the cry of one of his own, he woke up. Stop by today. I know it's tough. I know the going can be rough. But God is somewhere listening and leaning on the cry of a needed soul. So they woke up Jesus. And I believe they said, help us, Jesus,
to bail out this water. Yeah. That's often the case when we go to Jesus with our problems. We present to him not only the problem, but we present to him the solution. Yeah. God, I want out of the storm, but I want out like this. Yeah, Lord, I want you to bless me, but I want you to bless me like this. But God is sovereign. That means he can do what he want to do when he want to do it, to whom he want to do it to. Jesus wakes up with composure. Does not say a word to them. And the Bible says he makes the winds and the raging sea behave. And they ceased. Then he asked them and us a question. Where is your faith? After all, David said it in Psalm 62:11 that the power belongs to God. He says in Psalm 63:1-2, oh God, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh longs for you to see your power. Because of this power, we live on a ball called Earth. That's 25,000 miles in circumference. 8,000 miles in diameter. It weighs 13,170 and then 21 zeros after that. Y'all add that up. Whatever that means, right? But what I know it means that the earth is heavy. it's heavy. Yet it hangs on nothing. That's power. And it sits in space. Spinning 1,000 miles an hour, that's power. Yeah. We're spinning right now 1,000 miles an hour and not being pulled over. That's power. This is where and in whom our faith belongs. I go to my seat and answer the question of the disciples when they said in verse 25, what manner of man is this? For he commanded even the winds and the water, and they obey him. Who is he? He's the Ancient of Days. He's Adam's Redeemer. He's Abel's Vindicator. He's Noah's Ark. He's Abraham's Sacrifice. He's Isaac's Ram in the Bush. He's Samuel's Ebenezer. He's Isaiah's Prince of Peace. He's Elijah's Fire. Who is he? I'm glad you asked. He's Amos's Justice. He's Moses's Burning Bush. He's Joshua's battle axe. He's Gideon's fleece. And he's Samson's power. Who is he? Well, I'm glad you asked. He's David's music. He's Solomon's wisdom. He's Jeremiah's balm in a Gilead. He's Ezekiel's wheel in the middle of a wheel. He's Job's horse pawing in the valley. He's Daniel's lion tamer. Who is he? He's Matthew's king. He's Mark's suffering servant. He's Luke's great physician. He's John's made word flesh. He's Acts coming of the Holy Ghost. He already was. When he in the end, he always will be. He's bread in a starving land. He's the burden bearer, the creator of the universe, the deliverer and the day spring, the everlasting father, the eternal I am. He is faithful, a mighty fortress, a friend that sticks closer than a brother. He's God all by himself. He's in a class all by himself. He's immutable because he changes not. He's the keeper of our soul, the King of kings, the Lord of lords. He's merciful, mighty in battle. He never forgets us. He never forsakes us. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the pearl of the great prize. He's the true promise keeper. He's the resurrection that robs the grave of the victory and death of the sting. He's the rock of our salvation and the redeemer of mankind. He is sovereign. He's the hypostatic union, both man and God. He's the savior of the world, the great shepherd of the sheep. He's the truth that sets us free. He's unchangeable in his purpose, unequal in his power. He's the true vine. He's the word and the water. He's water in dry places. Who is he? He's the x-ray of my soul, the master physician, the self-existing, self-sustaining God. Can you
say yes? Can you say yes? He's unmatched in his attributes. He's unwavering in his beauty. He's unsurpassed in his care. He's unequal in his deity, unmerited in his love. He will never fail you or forsake you. He is good. He is great. He is our hope for tomorrow and our stormy tower. Can you say yes? He's Jesus, the storm stopper. That's why I know we should obey him. We should follow him. He moves, we should move. When he follows, we should follow him. When he speaks, we should listen. I stop by to tell you that he's Jesus, the storm stopper, because he never sleeps nor slumbers. If he slumbered, we wouldn't wake up. If he stopped speaking, we would not live. Jesus, the bright and the morning star, picks us up when we're lonely. My elder brother, if he repents, if we repent, he forgives us. And if we're in trouble, comes to see about us. Yeah. Jesus, the storm stopper.
This same Jesus is available right now. Whatever you may be going through, this is that opportunity right now. Call it discipleship if you want to call it that. But the door is open for 2,000 years ago. Why don't you come today? Why don't you bring it to him today? Why don't you make your way down? As a candidate for baptism, Christian experience, you can come by letter. Just come. Why don't you today? Come to Jesus. Bring it to him. Why don't you today? As the choir get ready to sing, this is your opportunity to come down and give your life to Christ.
You don't know
my story.
You don't know the peace. You cannot imagine the pain, the trial. Oh, you don't know. You don't know my story. You don't know my. Story today. He promised
he would never leave me.
My story proves
that God can do.
Oh, deliverance
is my testimony.
You don't know.
You don't know.
Hey.
My story.
Anybody got a story in the house? You don't know my story.
Life and favor
upon
me.
bless you.
Let me tell it.
God bless you.
Life and favor.
Why don't you? Why don't you?
God of mercy.
Yeah, yeah,
you
yeah.
You love me.
Why don't you?
Life and favor. Is my story, life and favor.
Why don't you come today?
What I've gone through.
Thank you for joining us by live streaming for our worship service today. We are now in the process of extending an invitation in our sanctuary, but I want to also extend an invitation to you, our viewers, if you don't know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins, that you might get to know him today. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10, that if thou wilt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So if you are a non-believer and you would like to confess Jesus Christ, if you want to become a Christian today, all you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. And it's just that simple. You are saved. Also, if you're interested in having us to pray for you, you can visit our website. There's a place there for you to submit a prayer request, or if you're interested in becoming a member of the Friendship Baptist Church in the colony, you can also visit our website, and there is a place there for you to make that request also. But most of all, thank you for joining us today via live streaming as we worship our God in spirit and in truth. May God bless you and keep you, and may you have a blessed week.